Do you think we can make hydrogen at home with electrolysis? Do you think maybe electrolysis and even use it to generate electricity?
Yes, we can.
Everybody is talking about hydrogen as the next big energy thing. It must be super complex, right? Otherwise, we'd already hydrogen-powered smartphones by now. And yet, here we are, still waiting for the future to arrive. We all know this kind of experimental board with a steam engine. Are you surprised now to see here an actual hydrogen system on it, ready to use at home? Hi, I'm Norbert, your friendly neighborhood energy engineer. Today I will show you how to make three different mind-blowing energy conversions, all on one board. Solar electric with the photovoltaic cells, electric to hydrogen with an electrolyzer, and hydrogen to electric with the hydrogen and the oxygen and the fuel cell, and then into the fan. Let's talk about why hydrogen is the future in a nutshell. It can be made from renewable electricity or from biomass, so we can produce hydrogen with our own means on our territory without depending from other countries. It is environmentally friendly. And you can store it for later, just like your leftover pizza, only less tasty. And it's perfect for mobile applications like transportation or mobile devices. Imagine a hydrogen-powered portable grid outlet, 240 volt or 110 volt. The European Union aims to produce and import 10 plus 10 million tons of hydrogen by 2030. Together, it is like the electrical energy for 150 million European households annually. We are only talking about electrical energy and only households. But wait, hydrogen isn't all rainbows and flowers. It's explosive. Boom! It's voluminous, so it needs high-pressure containers. Again, boom! And it is difficult to contain, because those super small thin atoms, they are really sneaky. We have four low-carbon ways to make hydrogen. One is biomass gasification. The second is electrolysis. The third one is biological processes with microorganisms. And then number four is thermochemical water splitting at high temperature. With the last two still in an experimental phase, we are left with two. What's the best then? Biomass or electrolysis? Biomass gasification. Great for large-scale production from biomass and even some of our waste. A stunning fact, in Europe alone, we can transform 170% of the natural gas equivalent we bought from Russia in 2021, using only suitable natural biogas that is in the European Union. I did a market analysis for ubi.org during the European project Blaze. This project was led by the Marconi University of Rome. It's about converting this suitable biomass to hydrogen and then to electricity in medium-sized plants. With all this biomass and adding also certain waste types like paper, plastic, tires, we have loads of raw materials for the production of hydrogen. Electrolysis. This is perfect for storing variable renewable electricity like that of the wind parks or sun energy or photovoltaic energy. And trust me, this is massive. Surely in the future when those plants will be many more. It solves the issue of excessive electricity, which is often sold at very low prices when there's enough wind and sun, but not enough demand on the grid. Electrolysis allows us to sell electricity at a much better price, so that investments in more solar parks will be even more attractive. And like gasoline, diesel and batteries, hydrogen can be used in transport. Batteries are great for transport, but not for massive electricity storage near big wind or solar power plants. I'm sorry guys, but we don't have enough stuff to make all those batteries. For those large amount of energy, check out my third alternative for large amount of energy in video 44. Before we dive into the experiment, I need your help to grow this educational channel for energy home do-it-yourself. Subscribe and join the climate conscious individuals who are kickstarting the energy transition right from our homes. Learn and implement sustainable solutions that prepare you for the future and also empower you to contribute to a better world. Drop after drop, filling a clean ocean. So let's get this hydrogen party started. So here we have the experiment. Here you see first the parts of the system. This is the solar energy, the solar PV panel. And then the plus and the minus go through this electrolyzer. And you see it here from nearby. And then here the electricity is led to the water. The water comes from the underside of this column, so that's distilled water, and that goes from this column here in the electrolyzer, and then here comes in this case the O2, so this oxygen that comes here, from here it goes from the electrolyzer, it goes into this column. Then you see here the bubbles coming, and then it will fill up this. So this water column will go down, and then you can measure here on the scale how much oxygen you produced. And the same is of course true also for the hydrogen. Two atoms of hydrogen in one molecule of water. So this column will go down twice as quick as this column. At the start, if you want to fill this, these two columns with water, you just fill it from here, and then you might have to take away these water ducts to the fuel cell in order that the air can escape. Okay, so then that's the electrolyzer. The electrolyzer takes the water from the both sides, and then it will produce this. Here you see the bubbles, oxygen, and here hydrogen. Okay, then the hydrogen is pushed here into the fuel cell, and the oxygen comes here, and the hydrogen comes from the other side, and then they are here recombined, and then you will get water, and the water is coming from here. If I open this, the two gases can go to the fuel cell and they can be recombined. And then if I put this connectors of the electric motor, you see it's turning. And then why does it stop? Because the gases cannot flow here in, because I put these steps, so they will find the pressure will build up here, and it you have no throughput, and then it will stop to make electricity, and then actually it will accumulate here. The gases will accumulate here, but if I take it away, then the gases will be consumed, and then it will always be here at the top, so you will not have an accumulation but just consumption from these gases in the fuel cell. So let's try it again. So there it goes. So, because there's a possibility of the water vapor or the gases, it comes here out, it can escape, and that means this gas can be consumed and it starts making electricity. So let's put it here in the sun and let's see if it makes a difference. So it's now in the sun. So you see that there are many bubbles now. Here are the bubbles of the hydrogen, and here are the bubbles coming out for the oxygen. So it would also be nice to see how much current, to measure the current which is produced by the fuel cell. Forty milliampere. If I give it a little push, then it's already spinning. And if I would be curious about how much voltage the fuel cell is producing, then I have to put in another connection. So it's less than 1 volt. Enough for the motor to spin slowly. So that's it. I hope you like this experiment. And you can see that we have now 3 conversions. So we go first from sun to electricity. The electricity goes into an electrolyzer. The electrolyzer makes the 2 gases, which are collected here. And then from here, it goes to the fuel cell. The fuel cell is making from this chemical energy the gases. It's making electricity again. And then the electricity goes into the fan, and that will make it spin. As you can see, With just 100 bucks, you can start producing hydrogen and electricity and solar energy all in the family. It might take a while for hydrogen storage to get competitive and be able to be compared to the use of the big infrastructures and the grid. But soon it will become possible to be independent from the grid and also the petrol station. Imagine powering your car or even your ride bike with self-made fuel. Share your thoughts about hydrogen as an energy in the comments below. I'd love to hear from your ideas and also your questions. And don't forget to subscribe and also to watch our playlist all about energy storage for more insights and also experiments.